Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hello everyone. This is Dr. Hashem Abu Serhan from Department of Ophthalmology in Hamad Medical Corporation, Doha, Qatar. I am introducing this YouTube channel to deliver different talks in ophthalmology and research, targeting mainly medical students, ophthalmology residents, and anyone interested in ophthalmology. I will talk about different topics in ophthalmology, covering both basics and clinical parts. In addition, I will explain how to publish your research papers from A to Z. I hope you find this channel fruitful and filled with useful content. So please like this channel, subscribe, and share it with your friends to help this channel grow up. Now I will leave you with a talk I delivered last year at Sinjab Academy about very interesting topics in ophthalmology and general history of cataract surgery. I hope you will find this lecture very interesting, so let's start.
I'm very thankful to be with you today. I'm going to deliver a little bit different talk. Eye snackoma, the title snackoma, originated from snacks and oma. Oma is a Latin word that means mass. So it's a mass of snacks, short, unique facts or stories in ophthalmology. First of all, it's spelled ophthalmology. If you don't get that part right, nothing else you do really matters. Nobel Prize in ophthalmology. Dr. Oliver Goldstrand is the only ophthalmologist who received the Nobel Prize in medicine in 1911 for his great invention, the slit lamp. The funny thing that he was in competition with Albert Einstein, and he was the one who won the prize. In the same regard, Dr. Gould's Gunin was a professor of ophthalmology who pioneered the procedure of ignipuncture, the first successful retinal detachment. He was seriously considered by the Nobel Committee in 1993 for the prize. A questionnaire was sent to ophthalmic authorities around the world. Among all of them, they replied with approval, with only one exception, that they believe that have come from an envious fellow countryman who argued the committee to postpone the award for 1 year. However, Gunin was died in the same year before the next prize was awarded. So the lesson is, envy is always a declaration of inferiority. Marcus Gunn, Joe Winking, or they said trigemino-oculomotor synkinesis. It's an abnormal connection between the motor branches of the oculomotor and the motor branches of the trigeminal and the oculomotor nerve. So it's an abnormal connection between the upper eyelid and the mouth. And this explains why when you examine patients with a slit lamp and ask them to open their eyes, they open their mouth instead. And also explain why you see females when they do mascara or makeup, they try to open their eyes, but actually they open their mouth instead. Sunglasses sign, one of the common beliefs among the public is that blind people usually wear sunglasses to their eye. An interesting paper was published in Neurology 2008. They found that the probability that a patient walking in a neuro-ophthalmology clinic had non-organic visual loss was 0.04. And this probability increased to 0.8 in patients wearing sunglasses. And the specificity for this sign was 99%. And they found that 96 of these patients who wearing sunglasses were found to review of system workers' compensation claims and disability. One of the interesting recently published papers in BMC Ophthalmology, they discussed the impact of cataract on color perception. They reported that cataracts significantly interfere with the colors saturations on the retinal image. I hear one of the surgeons proposing a new sign for cataract patient, SOC sign. He claimed that if you see a patient with different SOC colors in an ophthalmology clinic, you may consider him as or she as a cataract patient. Umm Kulthum is a well-known Egyptian singer. She has been named among the 200 greatest singers of all time. But there is one thing that has caught our eyes. Have you ever thought why Kulthum almost never seen hair without her famous sunglasses? Actually, she was suffering from thyroid eye disease. Her surgeons offered her a thyroidectomy with a risk to have hoarseness of voice post-op. So she decided to wear sunglasses to cover the proptosis and save her musical voice. The atropine was first made and extracted from belladonna, atropa belladonna plant. Belladonna means beautiful woman in Italian. And these atropine-rich extracts were used by Cleopatra to dilate her pupils in hope that she would appear more beautiful. And that's how they discovered the dilatation function of atropine. In the Middle Ages, the eye specialists in Arab countries were named the kahal. They had a privileged place in the royal household, especially during the Abbasid period. Ibn Ishaq al-Abadi was one of the most popular kahals in this period, and his book, The Ten Treatises on the Eye, is considered the first systematic textbook in ophthalmology known in the medical history. Now, let us speak up about the godfather of the new cataract surgery, Dr. Charles Kinman, and his great book about his story, Through My Eyes, and this video, circle video about phaco emulsification done by Dr. Charles Kinman himself. Before that, how cataract surgery was. ICCE was the primary surgery for cataract removal before Dr. Charles Kinman era. It has major drawbacks like large incisions with a slow healing, more surgical induced astigmatism, many reported complications like retinal detachment, corneal compensation. So cataract surgery was major surgery that needed lengthy hospital stays and extensive recovery periods and the use of large instruments, and the patient need to wear big goggles post-op. Who is Charles Kinman? Charles Kinman was born 1930 in New York. He invented phaco emulsification in 1976, and he faced a huge resistance in 1718 until he became an inspiration for overcoming resistance. Actually, what's strange about Dr. Kinman that his dream to be a popular music player and entertainer instead of being a doctor. Actually, this is what he did. He changed his name to Kerry Adam, and his telephone number songs topped up the US radio stations. He also delivered a new dance technique called the twist, but he was shocked when his dance was stolen and cited by another musician, the Chubby Checker. After his shock, he decided to continue his career in ophthalmology. This became true when he saw the front page of magazine, Look magazine, talking about Dr. Irving Cooper and his cryosurgery innovation for Parkinson's disease patients. He emailed Dr. Cooper to use his lab to try cryoprobes for cataract removal. And before the scientific publication of his new innovation, cryosurgery for cataract removal, he was stunned again when he saw a recently published paper talking about cryosurgery in cataract patients. Here in Manhattan Eye and Ear Hospital, the history changed in 1963. He received a 3-year research grant to propose a method for removing cataract through a small incision. So no hospitalization will be required. He tried many instruments, but he failed. In 1967, the sensational moment for Dr. Charles was made by the dentist, Dr. Larry. Dr. Kinman went to his clinic to whiten his teeth, and Dr. Larry at that time was using a dental bar with ultrasonic energy to whiten the teeth. He was inspired by him to develop the same technique for cataract removal. He tried his new technique on a blind eye. The surgery took 6 hours, and finally he destroyed the eye without any success. He kept trying until he succeeded in the fourth attempt. Kinman named the procedure phaco emulsification, and the cavitron was designed the first aspiration and irrigation system. He began teaching the courses and spread his new technique to the surgeons. However, phaco emulsification at that time faced significant criticism in 1917s and 18s. The National Eye Institute labeled the procedure as experimental malpractice, and you may lose your license. Because two main critiques. The first one, significant corneal damage. In fact, Dr. Kinman said that you need to destroy 40 corneas before learning the technique. And the second critique was the need to enlarge the incision again to load the IOLs, because at that time we don't have foldable IOL. However, this issue was overcome when Dr. Thomas Mazzacco invented the silicone IOL in 1984, what became known as Mazzacco Taco. Could be folded and inserted in the small incision used for phaco. After that, phaco started becoming the norm. So Being far ahead of your time is different from being wrong. Dr. Akahushi holds the world record for cataract surgery fastest time. He completed the entire case in just 1 minute and 20 seconds using his karate pre-chop technique without the need to scalp or groove. You just use this technique and eat the cataract material directly. And this is lastly how eye doctors open yogurt boxes versus normal people. This is just a funny video. And the take home message, never throughout history has a man who lived a life of ease left a name worth remembering. Thank you all.